Hi everybody, my name is Loic Deblais. I'm working in food safety and drug discovery, and today I'm going to present one of the technology we're developing in our lab, Dr. Rajshekar's lab, in order to improve the public safety around the world by controlling foodborne pathogen causing disease related to poultry, okay? So, I don't know you, but I love junk food. I could eat junk food, muffins, cookies, chicken wings, all the day, every day. And unfortunately, this kind of food have kind of side effect here. But I mean, when you look at Ohio, when winter is like 8 months every year, this layer of fat is kind of nice. It protects you against the cold weather. So it's kind of a good thing. But then summer is coming, you want to lose this extra pound. And unless you do a lot of sports, like this stay forever. But it would be incredibly nice if you have like the grail, the product that can make you lose all this extra pound during the winter before summer in a very short period of time. And now, what if I'm telling you that this grail is one of them, is called Salmonella. And it's not a lie. Salmonella is a bacteria, the foodborne pathogen that can make you lose a lot of pound in a very short period of time. The only side effect of it is that you will have to spend a significant period of your time in the restroom where you will be vomiting and pooping. Well, outside of these jokes, yes, Salmonella is a very big food safety issue we have in USA, but also worldwide. And just to give you an idea of how bad it is, for example, just in USA every year, we talk about millions of illnesses, thousands of hospitalizations, and hundreds of deaths. And we know this problem for now centuries. We try to fight this bacteria, but we have a big struggle controlling it. And the major problem we have is because the control method we are using, which the major control method we are using for poultry industry, are antibiotics and vaccine. And this technology start to be not well oriented anymore. For example, antibiotics have been used for a very long time. And we know now by fact that most of them are very broad spectrum. And we know also that in our body, chicken body or other animals, we have a lot of bacteria. These bacteria are not here to be pretty. They are very special for us because they transfer food into energy, but they also protect us against all the pathogens. So if you treat yourself for an infection, Salmonella, for example, and you use antibiotics, you will also disrupt your beneficial bacteria. And so at the end, over time, you will make yourself more susceptible for future diseases for a short period of time. The second problem we have with antibiotics is that they cannot be combined very well with other control methods, such as probiotics, which is the famous control we want to use now. And also, like I told you, we use antibiotics for a very long time, and we use it in a wrong way. And now, Salmonella, for example, is developing resistance mechanism, which makes these controls useless. On the other hand, what we have is vaccine. Vaccine is a great technology, very specific. But actually, it's too specific, because one vaccine may affect one or a few Salmonella, type of Salmonella. But when I'm talking Salmonella here, I'm talking about more than 2,500 different types of Salmonella that just only aim is just to make you sick or kill you. And so unless you want more than 2,000 different vaccines at the end, we really need to find an alternative to this problem. And nowadays, we know that pharmaceutical companies are developing a lot of new compounds. These compounds are called small molecules, and we believe in our lab, with Girish Rajshekara, that this compound can be a great candidate to be an alternative to the old technology, or can be complemented with the old technology. So this is just an example to tell you why we think these candidates, small molecules, are better than antibiotics, for example. On the left side, you have an antibiotic called colistin. It's a very big and complex structure, like you can see. And this colistin is commonly used in industry to fight many foodborne pathogens. On the right side, you have another compound called a small molecule. And you can see that this structure is very small and simple. And when you want to fight bacteria, most of the time, in general concept, size matters. Smaller is the compound you're using, and more efficient it will be, because it will probably go faster through the defense that the bacteria will build, and so it will probably kill the bacteria faster. And so what we are trying to do in our lab, and mostly for my research, is to identify small molecules that will be able to inhibit the growth of Salmonella, then kill the bacteria, and be able to protect chickens and us for the future against these pathogens. And so to do that now, in drug discovery, we do a very extensive work. Drug discovery is very long. It takes up to 6 to 10 years. It's very extensive, a lot of experiment. can be very boring sometimes or frustrating, because here what I'm talking about is that we start a project with thousands of compounds, and maybe if you are lucky at the end you might end up with one or two compounds that seems to be very promising for industrial application. And this is because we spend a lot of time making sure that all the compounds we identify are very efficient against salmonella, that are specific, so they will not affect beneficial bacteria, and will not be toxic for the host either. Okay? And so out of all these experiments, so for me, it took me so far 4 years, and I'm still far away to be done, we were able to find two compounds called SM4, SM5. And we really think that these two compounds can be great candidates as an alternative or be combined with other control methods, because we found that these two compounds were very specific to Salmonella and did not have any impact on probiotics, for example. They could be combined with these probiotics or also antibiotics. And so far, Salmonella could not build any defense mechanism. Okay? So based on this great result, we took these two compounds and we tested them on chicken. And I will just do an outline to explain to you why Salmonella is such a problem in chicken. Okay? So we know by facts that Salmonella is introduced in chicken by using contaminated water or food. And then when Salmonella is entering the chicken, it will colonize the whole intestinal tract, like you can see with the orange arrows, and then become systemic. It's when it becomes systemic, then the trouble are getting very important, because that means all your newborn chicken will be infested, the eggs you're going to produce will be infested, but also the feces will be highly infested. And this is a problem because feces are used for manure, as manure is a good fertilizer for agricultural purpose. Okay? And so most of the time in industry, when we suspect Salmonella is here, we treat the chicken with antibiotics. So these antibiotics will act on Salmonella, and we hope that these antibiotics will affect, reduce Salmonella in the chicken, and we will be able to increase the public safety and the environmental safety. But most of the cases, this do not happen because Salmonella persists extremely well in cica, spleen, and liver. And so what we want to do for our case is to quantify the amount of Salmonella in these three different tissues to make sure that our treatments will be able to reduce Salmonella and we will be able to increase the safety of the products we are promoting. So this experiment was that we did. We had chicken infected with Salmonella. We treated them with 1 mg/kg of small molecule for 5 days. And just to give you an idea of how much it is, it's about 5 to 20 times less than what we normally use in industry. So we did this to make sure that the compound we're identifying were highly effective against Salmonella and could be a very good product for future commercialization. And so what we found after our experiment is that indeed our small molecule were able to reduce Salmonella in these three tissues, or sometimes completely cure the chicken from Salmonella. So this was a great news. Also, what we found out after metagenomic analysis is that this compound did not disrupt the microbial population inside the chicken. So there's no potential side effect on the health of the chicken as well. So based on this great news, we were able to develop a patent with OSU, and these patents have been recently purchased by a company called MSD Animal Health, and we will hope to work soon with them to try to make this product commercializable and available for everybody. Also, as a conclusion of this, I'm very sad to say that now all the poultry produce will probably only make you gain weight. You will, I hope, not lose weight. And so this is the bad news of my research. I feel like I'm a little bit the bad guy. Well, of course, this research was very extensive, so I have to thank everybody in my lab. It was not only one person's work. And I would like to make you think about my whole story here. So I said that poultry is a major factor transmitting Salmonella. And one chicken can hold billions of Salmonella. And they can be fine. They won't be sick. But for your case, you just need one Salmonella, and you will be extremely sick. If you're not cured, you might die. So at some point, I will say whether chicken got Salmonella to protect themselves against us, or chicken tried to get rid of us. Thank you very much for your attention.